Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another video. Hope you guys are absolutely fantastic. In this video, let's have a look at this Aiko, this T400, a 720p, a native 720p budget projector. Hope you guys like this one. Stay tuned to the end because we're gonna do a series of tests. I'll leave a link down below so you guys can check it out, the price of the projector, and you'll be amazed. Don't expect to spend hundreds. Actually, this one is only two digits at the moment, costs $99. Imagine that, guys. Link down below so you guys can check it out. While we're doing this unboxing, if you're not subscribed to the channel, please consider subscribing. Click the red button. Thank you very much for that, guys. All right, let's remove everything from the package. Let's see what we have here, starting with the remote control. This is a typical projector remote control. Yeah, it does the job. You need to supply your own batteries. Yeah, not too bad. Moving on, you have the power lead here. And in my case, I also have an adapter for the UK plugs. There's also an AV cable, so you can plug your RCA devices, and an HDMI cable is also supplied. In the box, you can also find a quick user manual written in both English and Chinese. Oh, and there's this customer service card. And of course, guys, here we have the projector, the Aiko, this T400. This is a portable unit, as you can see. Just put it in your backpack. If you want, it will fit. On the front, you have this chrome bezel around the lens, the IR and the iCodis logo. On the side, there's plenty of ventilation here. You have the speaker there on the right, and two USBs, two HDMIs, one headphone jack, and one AV port. On the back, there's also a VGA port, so you can plug your laptop, for example. On the side, there's the power connector and some more ventilation. And at the bottom of the projector, there's some specs, like the projector model and the screw, so you can raise the projector like so. Finally, on the top of the projector, there's some buttons so you can control the menus, and you have your focus and keystone adjustment. So it's a manual focus, the lens go in and out depending on the distance of the projection. You can go from 30 inch to 120 inch with clear picture. Over here you have a keystone adjustment, just a vertical keystone in this case. Here you can find the buttons, power button, menu, source, just the typical ones. Overall, yeah, the projector looks good, but in my honest opinion, more important than the looks is the specs. This one has 3800 lumens of brightness from its LED lamp and a contrast of 3000:1. Like I mentioned, it has a 720p, which is HD quality, native resolution, and the manufacturer offers 3 years of warranty for this model, which is always good. And guys, without any further ado, let's put it to the test. Let's see what this budget T400 iCodis projector can do. All right, guys, so let's start by focusing the projector as best as we can. I think that's good. And here is the keystone adjustment. I think it's good. So this is the initial menu, so we have multimedia, HDMI is here, VGA, AV. Over here we have the setup, so you can adjust your picture settings, sound settings, time, options like the OSD languages. You have all these languages. Let's put it back to English. You can flip the screen, and here is the about. Okay, let's start our series of tests. So the projector is connected to the Mi Box, Mi Box 3 in this case. Let's start it with YouTube. Let's try another video here. Okay, guys, now let's do the test you normally do when you do these reviews of the projectors. Let's have a look at the white there, scale of grays. Here you can see the RGB colors. And we're going to move closer so we'll be able to see the sharpness of the projector itself. Like always, this is my hand for size comparison. Let me step back a bit. Normally, when we sharp the middle, there's a bit of blur here on the edges of the screen. It's not very noticeable, to be honest with you. Yeah, maybe slightly blur, but not too bad. The middle looks pretty good, the colors as well. And it's sharp as well. Have a look. This is my living room wall, so there's no screen here, just a wall painted in white. There's more lines there, so you guys can see the sharpness. Let's move to the other side. Let me try to focus here. Slightly blurry there. See this edge here? Yeah, guys, not too bad at all. For the price, I mean. Let me step back a bit. Let me turn the living room lights on. Alexa, turn on living room lights. So this is the living room lights, full brightness. Of course, you lose quite a lot of the image. Alexa, turn living room lights to 50%. Okay, 50% now. Looks all right. It's not perfect though. Alexa, turn off living room lights. Of course, when the room is pitch black, that's the best way to get the full potential of any projector, not just this one. Okay, guys, here is a good example of the sharpness of the projector. So in this area here, we can see it's pretty sharp indeed. But on the edges, there's a slightly blur on this area here. It's not noticeable enough, so we can tell. Have a look at those letters there in comparison to, for example, these ones there, even if you push it to the white background. Yeah. And there's a slightly darker area there, and there on the edges that is also noticeable. Here you can see the scales of grays. Black to pure white, same there. Yeah, I mean, for the price, it's pretty good. Here you can see how the colors cope with the movement. Of course, my camera is trying to focus the best it can, but it's not easy, especially in a darker room. Of course, guys, if you want to bring some friends over to play some games on a big screen, this is the way to do it. This is not me playing, it's just a video out of YouTube, but you guys can get the idea, of course. Of course, Netflix, you can have a good experience on the big screen. This won't replace a TV this size, but it gives you that cinema feeling, cinema effect that you cannot get on the TV.
You do the best, but then help a complete stranger for the good. Laugh until I cry.
Well, really good.
Really good.
Mr. Cole, sir.
In terms of fan noise, it's not too loud. For a small projector, I think it's all right. I've got my phone here with the decibel meter. I'm going to put it right next to the projector now. And now I'm going to turn the projector off. And back to the studio. Let's wrap the video, guys. I'll leave a link down below so you guys can check it out, this projector. Overall, for the price, I don't think you can ask for more. It has its faults, but overall, it's a good product. If you enjoyed the video, leave it a like button and subscribe to the channel. Guys, thank you very much for watching, and I hope I can see you all in the next one.